H.L. Mencken was born in Baltimore in 1880, died there in 1956, and was the most influential American journalist during the first half of the 20th century. He continues to have an impact today. Mencken was controversial and quite opinionated. Some called him the Barb of Baltimore. And though he couldn't have known exactly who would be elected twice to the office of president during the first decade of this century, listen to the words he wrote on July 26, 1920. As democracy is perfected, the office of the president represents more and more closely the inner soul of the people. We move toward a lofty ideal, and on some great and glorious day, the plain folks of the land will reach their heart's desire at last, and the White House will be adorned by a downright moron. H.L. Mencken wrote that more than 80 years ago. He understood more than we'll ever know. We think we're making progress. We better think again when we read what was written by H.L. Mencken's pen. Mencken's pen. A church is a place in which gentlemen who have never been to heaven brag about it to persons who will never get there. A judge is a law student who marks his own exam papers. In the United States, doing good has come to be, like patriotism, a favorite device of persons with something to sell. All men are frauds. The only difference between them is that some admit it. I myself deny it. Adultery is the application of democracy to love. Conscience is a mother-in-law whose visit never ends, and the inner voice that warns us that someone might be looking. Every election is a sort of advance auction sale of stolen goods. Never let your inferiors do you a favor. It will be extremely costly. I believe in only one thing, liberty. But I do not believe in liberty enough to want to force it upon anyone. H.L. Mencken wrote that more than 70 years ago, but the words still echo true, you know. We think we're making progress. We better think again when we read what was written by H.L. Mencken's pen. Mencken's pen. I never lecture, not because I am shy or a bad speaker, but simply because I detest the sort of people who go to lectures. I never smoked a cigarette until I was 9. If a politician found he had cannibals among his constituents, he would promise them missionaries for dinner. Criticism is prejudice made plausible. It is hard to believe that a man is telling the truth when you know that you would lie if you were in his place. In war, the heroes always outnumber the soldiers, 10-1. Faith may be defined briefly as an illogical belief in the occurrence of the improbable. In this world of sin and sorrow, there is always something to be thankful for. As for me, I rejoice that I am not a Republican. H.L. Mencken wrote that more than 60 years ago. He got a kick out of tweaking the status quo. We think we're making progress. We better think again when we read what was written by H.L. Mencken's pen. Mencken's pen. A legend is a lie that has attained the dignity of age. As the arteries grow hard, the heart grows soft. Love is the triumph of imagination over intelligence. Puritanism, the haunting fear that someone, somewhere may be happy. The theory seems to be that as long as a man is a failure, he is one of God's children. But that as soon as he succeeds, he's taken over by the devil. Say what you will about the Ten Commandments, you must always come back to the pleasant fact that there are only 10 of them. Democracy is a pathetic belief in the collective wisdom of individual ignorance. War will never cease until babies begin to come into the world with larger cerebrums and smaller adrenal glands. H.L. Mencken wrote that more than 50 years ago. Today it is still apropos. We think we're making progress. We better think again when we read what was written by H.L. Mencken's pen. Mencken's